Run CMC. Christian McCaffrey is Bay-bound. He is the newest San Francisco 49er. The deal, I'll give you the details here. The Panthers get a second-round pick this year, a third-round pick this coming year, a fourth-round pick this coming year, and a fifth-round pick in 2024. Here was head coach Kyle Shanahan on KNBR Radio earlier today talking about Christian McCaffrey.
In the last couple of days, we kind of saw that we had a chance to compete for him, and it turned up here. And I wish I could say that I was doing anything, but I'm not doing anything. So this isn't me. I'm sitting here coaching this team, getting ready for the Chiefs. And John's been working the phones, dealing with Carolina here for the last 48 hours, and keeps telling me we got a chance. It's getting close. And I'm sitting down here last night, just finishing up red zone and stuff. And right towards the end, I find out that we got it done. And I'm pretty excited, to tell you the truth.
So he's pretty excited. I think a lot of people are excited. Scott Fitterer, who is the Panthers GM, was asked about, you know, how many deals and all that stuff were actually put on the table for McCaffrey. Here's the back and forth with the media.
How many hard offers did you end up getting?
Three hard offers, and then a couple of like test the water type offers where they threw their hat in the ring and it was like, no, we're not going to go there. There are a lot of just like mid-level, hey, sniffing to see where it's at, really, more than anything.
So here's my question to you, Rami, and a question to everybody else listening and watching this show, whether it's on Sacktown Sports 1140 or it's YouTube.com, Sacktown Sports 1140. Was this an overpay by the Niners? 916-339-1140. The phone number is 1-800-920-1140. Was this an overpay for Christian McCaffrey?
My initial reaction, Nick, was like, whoa, like they gave up a lot. And if you asked me this, when did this deal happen? 12 hours ago, not even 12 hours ago, or a little over 12 hours ago, whatever it was, I might have said yes. But then the more you think about it, first of all, the position that the 49ers are in right now, there's a time to stockpile draft picks and there's a time to push all your chips to the center of the table. We all know the famous quote from the Rams GM at their parade that I can't say on these airwaves. So I think that there's a time to go all in. And if there's a time to go all in for the 49ers, it's not just this window that they're in right now, Nick, but it's this year, because all indications are you are handing the reins back over to Trey Lance next year, and we don't know what that looks like. And we talked a lot when they were handing the reins over to Trey Lance this year, if it was realistic to expect a team with a first-year quarterback, second-year guy with as little experience as a Trey Lance has to compete for a Super Bowl. And we're going to be asking that same question next year. Say what you want about Jimmy Garoppolo, but we know that they've gotten to an NFC championship and a Super Bowl with him at quarterback, which means you know you can get at least pretty close to that. So it's time to go all in. And on top of that, these third round picks that they traded, and look, they still don't have a lot of picks. Now they only have 2/3, a fifth, and a seventh in this year's draft. But they dealt away a pair of compensatory picks, essentially, that they had gotten for letting a couple of free agents walk away. So they're not as depleted in draft picks as some folks might think. And even if they were, this is a team that's competing for a Super Bowl this year, right now.
All right, I think you have to differentiate the player with the value and the price. And what I mean by that is I love Christian McCaffrey as a player. When he's healthy, it's very difficult to not love the guy. But this is an insane overpay. This is absolutely no doubt an overpay. And now you have to win. I mean, if you don't win the Super Bowl, you'll look back at some of these moves and this trade in particular, and you're left scratching your head. I know it's not a rental. He still has a couple of years left on his deal, but this is an overpay. Doug Kide of Pro Football Focus wrote about it today. He said, you know, look, the Niners have 3 third-round picks in 2023 because of the compensation. So, you know, they deal one of those picks. But when you look at the old Jimmy Johnson valuation model, when you look at draft picks, this essentially is giving up a first-round pick for Christian McCaffrey. And when you look at what he's done the past couple of years, you go back to, you know, 2018, 2019, his numbers are much better. His, you know, wins above replacement per season is much higher. And now you look at something like the Eagles, what they gave up for A.J. Brown, which was a first round pick and third round pick. And you look at that, you know, wins above replacement statistic. You know, there's no doubt that value-wise, the Niners overpaid. This is somebody, as great as he's been, he has been incapable of staying on the football field. And that's a big issue for me. I can't guarantee you that Christian McCaffrey will be playing by December the way his recent history has gone.
That's a fair concern on your part. There's no doubt about that.
It's a huge concern.
Yeah.
And when you it's not only this particular trade. The other thing about this deal is that you look at what John Lynch and Kyle Shanahan have invested in the running back position. It's ridiculous. The running back position.
That's true. You know what? That is true.
It's not very valuable. The running back position in the NFL is not a big market. You're not supposed to pay a lot of money for running backs. You're not supposed to spend first round picks for running backs. And when you look at it, this is crazy. Okay. The Niners, since the 2021 draft, the Niners have now spent 8 draft picks on the running back position. They gave up 2 fourth-round picks to move up to get Trey Sermon. I remind you that they took Sermon, and they could have traded him to the Eagles. They decided not to and ended up releasing him and getting absolutely zero for him. So they traded 2 fourth-round picks to draft Sermon in the 3rd round. They picked Elijah Mitchell in the 6th round. They picked Davis Price this year in the 3rd round. And now they traded a 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and 5th for Run CMC. That is 8 draft picks invested in the running back position, which is a position that everybody in the NFL would tell you is not a position that you dump a bunch of assets into. And that's what Lynch has done.
Now that I can't defend, but some of it you can chalk up to injury, but some of it is just missing on guys and mishandling of the position, Nick. There's nothing I can say to defend that. But when you talk about how much they've invested in the running back position, when you talk about how much they gave up in this for McCaffrey specifically, I think that you have to look at it in the context of how Kyle Shanahan runs his offense. And it's very reliant on the running back position, to the point that where when they didn't have a running back last year, he took his best receiver and put him at running back. And maybe that says something about Kyle Shanahan, and he's behind the times in valuing the running back, or having to value the running back position so much for the style of offense that he runs. But also you have to look at it in the context of what I just said, that this is a team that is in a Super Bowl window, and that window might be closing at the end of this season. So what are you saving these draft picks for? And on top of that, Nick, when you look at the team that they're going to be putting around Trey Lance starting next year, it's not like this team is going to age out very fast. A lot of these guys are still young, in their mid-20s, and with the exception of Bosa, locked up contractually for years to come. So your roster is not going to get depleted to the point where I think you're going to miss these draft picks. Everything you said is true, but I also think that in the context of the 49ers, outside of the big picture at the running back position, I can't defend that. There's no context that can defend that. But outside of that, I think when you look at the context of the 49ers and where they are as an organization, I think the trade makes sense. It's a steep price to pay. I just don't know what else you were going to do with those resources that were going to do more to help you in the goal, the end game of winning a Super Bowl in 2022.
This is a roster that has lots of free agency, you know, situations and decisions to make here this offseason. I think more than half of their roster is going to be in free agency this offseason. Now you have less draft picks to address possible holes that you may have due to that free agency. I would also argue, if you're investing this much into running back, what are you not investing in? Because there are other positions that you could address on this roster, maybe before the trading deadline, dependent on the injury situation. And now you spend all of this capital into another running back. And on top of all of that, I would say that Kyle Shanahan and his history has proven he could take other guys. He could take a Davis Price. He could take an Elijah Mitchell. He could take a Jeff Wilson and get more out of the running back position because of the scheme. I love the player. But I don't think there is any argument somebody can give me and throw back at me that tells me this is not an overpay. And they absolutely have to win it now. There's no if you win it, you can justify everything. We know that, right? You win a championship, it justifies everything. But this is an overpay. When you look at it in a vacuum, absolutely an overpay. I want people's thoughts on this. 916-339-1140 is the text line. You can check us out, youtube.com/C/SacktownSports1140. Do you think this was an overpay by the Niners? And was it a massive overpay? We'll get to some of your reaction.